ARES Commander Edition 2014 increases your productivity with new tools to organize and manage layers. Among features related to layers, we would like to emphasize the new Layer Preview. We can access the command from this icon, or write Layer Preview in the command line. Layer Preview provides a simple way to view the elements in each layer. Clearly, an extremely useful tool, especially when working with projects created by another person or another company. With a click, we can get to know the elements on each layer. It's just amazing. When you browse through Layer Preview, you are activating and deactivating layers. If we have selected some layers for preview, we can decide what should happen when we close the dialog. We can use this checkbox to restore or not the layer state before preview. By default, Layer Preview will restore the state, but I can uncheck the box. If I do so and close the dialog, the layers will remain like in the preview. Now I'll return to Layer Preview. Something similar happens with this other option. This enables us to restore the view we had before using Layer Preview. This option exists because while we're previewing the layers, we have the ability to browse the project using the Preview button, which includes the possibility to move, zoom, and pan. And therefore, we're changing the view we had before using Layer Preview. Selecting Escape, I return to Layer Preview. And so now I have a choice whether or not to restore the previous view. Given that we have used zoom and pan during preview, we choose to restore the previous view and select Close. You'll notice that there's a small zoom adjustment. Let's return to Layer Preview. Please note that in Layer Preview, we can use different keystrokes to select layers. For example, clicking on the layers to activate them one by one. To activate several layers at once, you can drag the pointer to select them. This can also be done by selecting a layer, pressing Shift, and selecting the last layer of the group. As a result, all the intermediate layers are selected. If we want to select all the layers at once, we can use Control A for all. If we are looking for a specific layer, we can use a filter. This button, Delete, deletes the layers that are empty. That is, if we select a layer and there are no objects in that layer, the Delete button will be enabled. If the layer contains any objects at all, the Delete button will be disabled. But there's more. Using this drop-down icon, we find more tools related to layers. The first one, Activate Layer, defines the current layer by selecting an entity. For example, we select this text, and the layer of this entity becomes the current one. In this way, any entity that we create from now on will be created directly in this layer. The second option allows you to change the layer of selected entities. For example, we select the street and select the layer to assign by clicking on an entity belonging to the new layer. We've actually moved the entity from the layer street to the layer of the sign. When selecting street, we can see that the layer is now the same as for the sign. We also have tools to restore the previous state of layers. More to move an entity from one layer to the current layer. Others to delete layers, but only those that are empty. What's important, ARES now has the tools to allow us to be more productive when working on a complex project. If you want to know more about these tools, just press F1 and in the search or filter area, write Layers, and then go to Layer Tools, where you'll find all the help you need.